In this video, we'll look at using loops and the loop library in Mixcraft 10. We'll also add other locations in case you have your own loop folders already on your computer. Plus, I'll check out the store to see if we can grab some more free loops, or you can purchase loops from there as well. But first, let's start to put together a song using the included loops that come with Mixcraft 10. So first, we'll need to create a project, and you can do that from creating a new blank one or use a template or whatever it is you want. I'm going to use my template here because it already has some tracks in it, and I can easily drag my loops into there. Now, what we want to do is go down to this bottom area here, and if it's hidden on you like this, you can just click somewhere on here, and we want to go into the library. That's what we're going to be checking out today. If I go to sort by date, it's going to show all almost 8,000 items that are in here. So obviously, we want to restrict how we're looking for our loops in here. So we can go to song kit, and that kind of puts together these folders here that includes loops that will all work together. So we can easily put together a song just from using loops within one of these folders. So let's go ahead and do that right now. And if you look, there's a ton of different styles in here, from rock sounds to hip hop to EDM styles, country, pop, jazz, and more. There's lots of stuff in here, so you can have a lot of fun with it. And of course, mix and match things once you get at this. But I think for this song, I want to go with this mellow piano rock. I think that should go well with the video. And if we look in this folder, there's a lot of loops that we can start building our track with. Now, one thing I'm going to do is add a drum track here because I don't have an audio drum track. I just have an instrument drum track up there. So I'm just going to add this track and I'm going to call it drums. So then that way I can just bring my drums up there. And that's where I like to start. So let's have a look at the drums that we have here. And if you want to listen to any of these, you can just press this little triangle here and it will play. All right, so that's a pretty basic drum beat, and you can go through and test out all the ones till you find something you like. You can see there's a lot in here. You even have drum breaks, drums end, fills. So you can really put together a full song. There's intros in here, lots of stuff to work with. I'm just going to go with drums one. So one thing to notice is the tempo of these files in here are just about 70 BPM and the tempo of our project is 120. Now, when we do a playback, Mixcraft tries to get it close enough to our project tempo so it kind of blends together. So let's just kind of try that right now. Let's just add something from another one. We'll add Latin rock because that's close to 120. So we'll add that in there. And let's just use the click track. And you can see it's beat matched that, so this 117 fits into our 120. Now let's go back to our piano rock. So now if we want to hear how these drums will fit in with this tempo, not at 70, we can just start playing our song and then play this. So that's pretty cool. It's going to kind of beat match. So let's add these drums in there right now. And if we zoom in, you can see it's lined things up nicely. So it's taken a 70 BPM tempo and moved it up to 120. Now that's if we just want to match the current project, but there's another way that we can do this. So now if we want to put together a song using these files, we might want to keep that BPM. So let's drag this in here. And now it asks us, do we want to switch to a tempo of 69 and a key of A with a 4/4 time? Let's say yes. And now you can see it switched our project. We have a 69 tempo and an A for our key. So let's listen to that. It's a lot slower than when we previously added this to the 120 BPM. So this gives you a lot of flexibility with how these loops are going to sound, because when you start changing things up, it really changes the sound of them. Now let's look at adding a bass, and we'll just go to B1 here and we'll play this back. That sounds good to me. Let's add that to our project, and I'll put that on the bass track here. Now let's see what we have for piano. And we went with the B1 for the bass, so let's add the B1 for the piano. I'm not even going to listen to it. I'm going to put it on this vocal track here, and I'll rename that to piano. Let's hear how this is sounding. Really cool. That's got like a Radiohead vibe to it. And we'll also add this acoustic guitar here. We'll put that guitar one. And what else do they have in here that we can add? So we can also add this guitar A1. So that'll be like guitar one, guitar two. We'll add that in here. And I'm just going to take out these other tracks that we're not using. All right, so now let's listen to what we've got so far. It's a really cool sounding track, but you'll notice it was clipping. So you will want to go into the mixer, adjust the levels, do some panning and things like that to bring your levels down and make everything kind of blend together a little nicer. But what I want to do right now is look at using these loops and moving them around in the timeline a bit. So we have like this one section here. Now, what if we wanted to make this into two sections? Well, one thing we could do is hold Alt down on our computer keyboard and then click and drag the clip that we want to duplicate, and we can just drop it next to it. That's one way to do it. Another way to do it would be to use this little icon here. It says plus one loop. So click it once, loops once, click it again, and it'll loop again. You can keep doing that as much as you want. And there's another way we can do that, and that's just by dragging. So you keep dragging it to loop it however many times you want. And you can do that for all of your loops. If we highlight all of them and then we do this, you'll notice that we can drag all of our loops at the same time. So that can save you a lot of time if you're working on a section of a song like this and you want to loop the whole thing. That's something really cool that we can do. Now, what about if you have existing loops on your computer and you want to add those in? Let's click on this little folder icon here, and you can see if you hover over it, it says browse your computer. So we can add a folder, and I'm going to go to my documents. So I know this folder has some loops in it. I'm going to click select folder. And if you look, it's adding all of those loops into my library. And you can see in here, there's some information like file location. Maybe we don't want to see that. If you right click on here, we can just uncheck that. And now we can see format, album, composer, and we can add description in there if you want. You can add style. If there's style information attached to it, it could bring that in there. And if I click on here, because my folder already had subfolders in it, we can start to look at the different subfolders in here. So if you put together your loop folders with subfolders, it can make it easier for you to find ones that you've downloaded from other places. So that's adding your own loop folder in there. And if there's some things in here that you want to favorite, you can put a little star right beside them, and then you can go into your favorite section, which is right here, and it's going to show your favorites. So that's a look at using our library here. Now, if we go to the new store tab that we have down here in Mixcraft 10, and then we go over here and change this to loops, you can see there's some loops in here, and you can purchase a couple of these packs, but there's also packs that you can download for free. So let's look at adding this Michigan Audio Lab Loops and Samples pack. And if we click here, we can listen to it. So that gives us a little sample of what's going to be in there. Again, we can do that with this one.
Bow, 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 bow.
All right, I might want to add this one because it's a little funky. And all we have to do is just click install. And you can go here. And if we want, we can install the other ones and they would all be listed here. Then we would just click download. And it's going to download all of the loops that are in that free pack once we hit that install button. So let's close that down. And if we go here to library and now import date, you can see these are the soundtrack loops that we just installed. So this is everything that we just installed. Let's have a listen. And it's important to note that it's not actually downloading all of these on your computer right away. You'll notice if I click here, there's going to be a little pause because that's when it's going to be downloading on your computer. So you're not loading up your computer with a ton of files that you're not going to use. You're just going to download the ones that you want to check out or that you actually do want to use. So there's a look at the store tab and getting some more loops in there. And you should keep checking back in this tab every now and then because you never know when they might add some more free stuff in there, or you can check out some of these deals on other loop packs that they're going to add in there. And as your songs start to come together, you're going to want to control the volume, the panning, and maybe do some automation, which is what we're going to look at in the next video.